Here I'm going to discuss modeling human motion. But why would we model human motion? And we have in fact three main reasons why we want to model these human motions. On one hand, we want to use it for programming by demonstration, such that we can rapidly deploy our more generic applications at a specific site. On the other hand, we also want to use these human motions to anticipate and predict human motions in the neighborhood of the robot. For example, to avoid the human, or for example, in a handover between the human and the robot. And thirdly, even more closer in interaction with the human, we want to use these human motion models for shared control. And it's our ambition that we use the same methodology for these three goals. And it's also important to realize that because we have our model-based reactive approach, that we want also to include this human model inside the reactive skill. So it needs to be compatible with reactive control and compatible with our constraint-based approach. If we want to model the human behavior, of course, we first have to measure it and demonstrate the task segments in order to establish these models. When we record these task segments, we can measure both poses and wrenches so that we have the complete motion and interaction with the environment. We basically measure these segments in two ways. First, we have kinesthetic teaching, where you take the robot by hand under force control and drag the robot according to the task. This approach ensures feasibility and requires much less calibration efforts because, of course, the demonstration setup is exactly the same as the execution setup. An additional advantage of this approach is that on top of the force control, we can add other behaviors, for example, to achieve a kind of impedance control that already seeds the demonstrations with the previous demonstrations. Also, a problem with this kinesthetic teaching is that, of course, it's an active control system, a force controller, and it has much more disturbance forces than a free motion in space. Then passive observation, that's just a position measurement system and a force sensor. There, of course, the feasibility is not guaranteed anymore. We have to be a little bit more careful about the calibration. And but the advantage here is that our demonstrations are much less disturbed by control errors. So, what is the method that we use for modeling these human motions? Then we inspired us on these flexible trajectories, and we used a statistical method, principal component analysis, a probabilistic principal component analysis, such that we can establish a number of basis functions, a limited number of basis functions, and a trajectory of the human is represented by a linear combination of these basis functions. And that's exactly the same model that we had for these flexible trajectories. And so it's clear that these human motion models are very easily transposable to ATASL. Also important for this learned trajectory is that this learning captures the variations of the trajectories. And for example, if you have a trajectory that's quite precise at the beginning and at the end, but has some variations in the middle, the probabilistic model will capture these variations. Not only that, it also captures the correlations along the trajectory. If there is always a systematic deviation on one hand corresponding to a systematic deviation on the other hand, this correlation will be captured by the model. A first application of this programming by demonstration techniques is an application for the assembly of solenoids in a block. And these solenoids need to be inserted into the block, but this block can be located at different locations. The location of this block is observed by a camera system. But first, we need to demonstrate a number of feasible trajectories, and that you see doing right now. And after these demonstrations, you can also use guided demonstrations, incremental demonstrations, such that information of previous demonstrations is already used to impose a kind of impedance behavior on the robot, such that it's easier to demonstrate the task. And so you can tune up a demonstration by letting it go and putting it away when it starts deviating from what you want to have. Then, after the demonstrations, we can use these motion models for the execution. In these motion models, the motion of the robot is these motion models that have variations are combined with the vision constraints that determine the location of the block. And let's say the most similar trajectory to the demonstration that still achieves the constraint is selected, and the robot is moving according to that trajectory. We use the same approach to define a more general task consisting of an approach and contact phase. And using this more general task, we first demonstrated a beer opening case, where you move towards the beer in free space until you make contact, and then while maintaining contact, you open the beer. After these demonstrations, we can execute the task, and you can see that even when there are variations in position and orientation, we can still successfully execute this task. And even when we change the type of bottle of beer, then the task is still programmed. So the robot has learned the correct combination between poses and positions and wrenches. Then, using the same generalized skill, we demonstrate a completely different task, contour following, where again we move first in free space to make contact, and then we maintain contact to execute the task, in this case the contour following. Then we execute this task, and now we also demonstrate disturbances, and because we have a model-based system, we can still add additional behaviors to the system. And then you have motion in free space until you make contact, and then it starts executing the contact task. It's important to note that the position of this contour is not exactly the same, and our approach is still works when this position is varied significantly, although our approach currently is not really able to handle large variations of the orientation.